Hello, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is David, and in this video I'm gonna explain to you how to play the game Touché. I don't know if you call it that in English, but that's how we call it here in the Netherlands. And you or your team win the game by being the first player or team that created three different patterns on the board. And you make a pattern by putting your pawn on the board by playing a matching card. And that's basically the game. But be aware, you can also mess up the patterns of your opponents. So please let me show you how it's played. The game contains the game board, a set of markers. There are three colors. If you're playing with two or three players, each player takes one color and you will compete among each other. If you're with four or six players, then the markers are shared between the teams. But as in the single game, each player will get his own deck of cards. There are two stacks of cards, that being the classic cards from two up to the ace, including three joker cards per set, so six joker cards total. The starting player is the player who draws the highest numbered card from the deck, and that player divides all cards equally among the players till all cards are dealt. Then all players will take the top five cards in their hands, and then we're ready to start the game. And the aim of the game is to be the first player to have three of those four patterns made on the board. The square only uses four markers. The other three patterns use five markers, being a T-shape, a straight line, or a cross. And it doesn't matter if they're horizontal or vertical or diagonally. You can make them however you want. And the first player or team to have completed three different patterns is the winner. So keep this next to the board so you can always look how the patterns work. And when it's your turn, it's rather straightforward. You play a card and you can put your marker on a space matching that card. And all cards are twice on the board. So in this case, if I play the Queen of Hearts, I can take my marker and put it on either this location, or I can put it on this location, as long as that location is free. Once I've put my marker here and the blue player has also the Queen of Hearts, then that player has no choice but to put it over here. And when you played your card and played the marker, you will draw a new card from your deck, so you have five cards in your hand again, and then it's the next player. Well, that player will play, I'll just randomly draw some cards, that will be over here, and this player will play the hearts nine, and the player may want to put it over here, so that decreases my chance of making a square. And now it's my turn again, and I will play this card. Keep in mind, the black markers are not a player's color. We will use them once a player completed his pattern. And so play goes on while you're trying to make your pattern. But you can also try to mess up other players' patterns by placing your marker somewhere in between, so that they cannot complete their pattern anymore. Once a player has completed a valid pattern, like in this case a square, that player will call Touché, and then all other markers are returned back to the owner, except for the one that made the pattern. And you'll put the black markers on top of them. And these will stay on the board for the rest of the game, and they cannot be used again. Everybody keeps the cards in the hands they have, they keep their own stack of cards. We just continue the game, and the player who made the figure can start a new round by playing a card and placing a marker. Should you get a card in your hand where it's not possible to place a marker, because maybe one of them is blocked by a completed pattern and the other is blocked by another player, then you can discard the card and draw a new one. And then you will try to complete one of the other patterns. Like I said, you can block your opponent by putting pawns in the way of their pattern so they can't complete it anymore. The only exception to that is a joker card. If you play a joker card, you can put your marker anywhere on the board you want, except for those free spaces. I will explain them in a moment, but for now you can just simply put your marker anywhere on the board you want. You can even take over the space of an opponent. So maybe I want to remove this yellow marker and put my own marker over there, and then this one returns to its owner. So the only way to remove your opponent's markers is by playing a joker card. So that can also really mess up your plans. Then we have these free spaces on the board, empty spaces. You can only use them to complete a pattern. So, for example, if my markers are like this, I only need a marker over here to complete the cross. Then I can play any card I want, doesn't matter. I can pick my own card and then I can put my marker on top of this empty space. We have a touché, so the cross will get its black markers and all other markers are returned to their owners. But that's the only way you can occupy a free space. Once a player takes the last card from its deck, so if I have four cards in my hand and I take the last card from my stack, from my draw deck, then that player has to collect all discarded cards from itself but also from all other players. He'll give them a good shuffle and distribute the cards evenly among all the players, like in the setup, and players that still have cards in their deck will put the new cards they get underneath the cards they still have and then will continue to play. And so it's a race to be the first player or the first team to complete three of the four patterns. If you're playing in teams, the team players are not allowed to sit next to each other, and of course they are not allowed to communicate about the cards they have in their hands. But that is the game Touché. Very straightforward. If you want to put your marker on a certain space, you will need to play a card matching that space. And if you don't have the right cards in your hand for your pattern, you can maybe try to make another pattern somewhere else, or you can try to mess up your opponent's patterns. So be aware that this can be a very frustrating game if all your patterns get blocked constantly by the other players, especially of course when you already have completed two patterns, there will be other players trying to prevent you from winning. But that is how Touché is played. If you have any questions about it, please feel free to ask them in the comments below. My name is David, thank you for watching, and hope to see you next time.